It may appear that these cowboys are wandering the streets of Tombstone, Arizona, but they're actually a few miles west of Trenton, kicking up the dust at Herbietown, the backyard creation of Herbert Adams, with the loving support of his wife, Marie.
35, maybe 40 years ago, I just started building the building, building the building. Of course, you know, I've been a carpenter. And of course, everything is built out of good old lumber. Some of it as much as probably, well, the barn down there, most of it's out of a barn that was 92 year old from over in Crockett County. And first thing I know, you know, they was friends, you know, they throughout the years, they come look at it, you know, walk through it, and I kept, well, I'm still adding to it.
And there's plenty of room to grow. Herbietown encompasses about 2.5 acres of a 38-acre spread. Except for the old gas pump and a few other odds and ends, the town generally represents the West of about 100 to 125 years ago.
I love Westerns. That's all I watch, you might say. Well, except a little preaching now and then, you know, on those tubes, but I watch Westerns. And I just always like, you know, old buildings, old barns. Even back when I was a small boy.
When I walked into the town, I thought of John Wayne and the great John Ford Westerns. Guess what? So did Herbert. He has John Wayne pictures all around his workshop and a few in town.
Well, I got him in the saloon, and then he's in another place, Old Country Store, I think. A life-size picture of him, you know.
I think it's great. It gets to be a little much sometimes, but I've enjoyed it. And he has really worked hard, so that makes it more exciting, I guess. I've really enjoyed the saloon. I guess one reason is because our grandson got married in there, and it was kind of outstanding. Everybody seemed like they really liked it. It was a Western wedding. And of course, I liked the chapel. Well, I like it all. To tell you the truth, I don't guess I really have a favorite. I said, Herbert, can I be a can-can girl? No, you know. And I told somebody, they said, I don't think you can do that. I said, you want a bet? I said, well, I'll be Miss Kitty. But we have fun. A church group came by, and I was the bartender, and I was pouring the preacher a drink, and they was making pictures. He said, y'all are getting me in trouble. It was a group from Trenton. We had a lot of fun. So, yeah, I like the saloon.
She would make a nice can-can girl, but she wanted off on Wednesday night to go to prayer meeting. So I, you know, that leave me one short. So I didn't holler.
Herbert had the kids in mind as he built Herbietown, a place to teach a new generation what life used to be like and to show them the tools that tame the frontier.
How's everything doing? Good to have y'all.
Thanks.
Both he and Marie love to watch the faces of visitors as they enter the town.
Oh, I enjoy that. I can tell the ones that's gonna enjoy it just as soon as they walk into it. You know, they are some, man, they're just inquisitive. Their eyes don't miss nothing hardly much, you know. I enjoy watching them. Grown up, and the kids too.
It makes you feel happy and proud. When you're working on it, you think, oh, why? But then when you see that they enjoy it, it makes you feel real good.
You will find just a little bit of everything. You will find a lot of old farming tools. Corn grinders, wash boards, tubs, hay rakes, hay balers, just about anything you want to see is here. We got a saloon, old country store, which has got stuff dated way back. Look magazine back in 1940. We've got a little chapel that we finished up probably, about a year ago, which is good for a Western wedding, let me throw that in. We planning on doing that. We can ride them across a covered bridge in a buggy or a hack or whatever they want to ride in. We got a lot of old wagons. We got sleds, snow sleds I built. We've got buggies I built. We've got some that was given to me. Just about anything you want to see is here.
Herbert's next projects will break tradition a little bit. For the kids, he's going to build a house of mirrors and an old-fashioned fun house.
I haven't learned to go to the coffee shop, like a lot of guys. You know, they'll get there about 6:30 or 7, they'll stay to 9:30. That's not for me. My hands have got to be busy. Of course, I learned to sit down one of these days. I hope I don't, but I probably will.
It's obvious that Herbert can run circles around many of us. So what's his philosophy for longevity and energy?
Don't worry. I think worry is probably one of them. To me, it's about one of the worst things you can do. Just be happy. And I think you can train yourself to that. But I have a hard time with my wife. She thinks the worst thing's gonna happen every day, you know. But I don't worry. Of course, you know, I get concerned about stuff, but as far as worrying and can't sleep and all that, there's nothing gonna worry me without some of the family gets sick, you know.
Herbie Town is open Fridays and Saturdays from 8 to 6, and at your convenience, by appointment.
But I just always loved old lumber, loved the bills. And I always wanted to own a town. And there's something else that I've always wanted. I've always wanted a highway that would go all over the world. One way, nobody on it but you, you know. So maybe I'll do that next, you know.